अनअकैडमी इज प्रोवाइडिंग डेली T20 फ्री प्रैक्टिस टेस्ट फॉर बोथ TS एंड APM सेट. इट हैज स्टार्टेड ऑन नवंबर 2. Week 1 कंटेन्स बायोलॉजी, जुअलॉजी, फिजिक्स, केमिस्ट्री, मैथमेटिक्स. इन Week 1 देर विल बी 5 क्विजेस, इन Week 2 देर विल बी 5 क्विजेस, एंड इन Week 2 क्विज विल बी ऑन बॉटनी, जुअलॉजी, फिजिक्स, केमिस्ट्री एंड मैथमेटिक्स. एंड Week 4 क्विज विल बी 4 क्विजेस. सो द क्विज विल बी ऑन बॉटनी, जुअलॉजी, फिजिक्स एंड केमिस्ट्री. डोंट फॉरगेट टू एनरोल फॉर अन अकेडमी एंड मेक श्योर यू गिव दिस फ्री प्रैक्टिस रजिस्टर टू अन अकेडमी ऐप एंड एक्सप्लोर द एंटायर ऐप बिकॉज देर विल बी मेनी क्विजेस, यू मेनी लेक्चर्स. सो जस्ट रजिस्टर, डाउनलोड द अन अकेडमी ऐप. इट्स फॉर एब्सोल्यूटली फ्री ऑफ कॉस्ट एंड ऑल्सो मेक श्योर टू एक्सप्लोर द एंटायर ऐप. See what are NEET exam day guidelines. Okay, so first what you need to do is you need to fill self declaration form. There is a form called self declaration form. Self declaration form is very important. Without this self declaration form, you are not allowed to attend exam. Okay, most of the students will have doubt. So why we need to fill self declaration form? Self declaration form is nothing but it will ask you, are you having any virus? Are you having symptoms of the virus? And do you have any flu-like symptoms in the last 14 days? And have you traveled from any city or any country? And did you come into contact with any person who is affected with this virus? So all these things will be asked in the self-declaration form, okay? So the main motto of self-declaration form is NTA wants to make sure that every student attending this exam is completely safe. Okay, so self-declaration form and admit card both are very important. And coming to this particular form, you will need to paste a passport size photograph. They'll give you a small space. In that space only you need to stick your passport size photograph. But the self-declaration form also needs your signature and your parent's signature. Okay, so all these things you must make sure before the exam day only you have to take your parent's signature. Okay, so now let's see other guidelines. Okay, so you must carry your admit card, your ID card, and you must reach exam center at least 1 hour before, because due to this pandemic there is thorough checking going on in each and every exam center. So they are checking your temperature, are you having any flu symptoms, so all these things. And they will also scan the barcode which is on the admit card. It is best if you carry 4 passport size photos along with you for the safe side. So coming to the ID proof, you must also carry your ID proof. Okay, so coming to ID proof, now I'm going to tell you what are valid ID proofs. Okay, driving license, PAN card, Aadhaar card, voter ID or ration card, passport, these all comes under valid photo ID proof. Okay, you can take any one of them. Okay, so now let's see how to score 600 plus marks in NEET. Okay, so first most important tip is you need to attempt at least 150 questions correctly. Okay, so if you attempt at least 150 questions correctly, there will be high chances of you getting 600 plus marks. Okay, so if you are not sure about any particular question, or if you are not knowing the correct answer for any particular question, just leave that question completely, because you have negative marking. So in order to avoid negative marking, it's suggested not to take any risk by guessing. Okay, So next important tip is you need to concentrate on weak subjects on so you need to concentrate on weak subjects and topics. Weak subjects and topics. Okay, so out of three subjects in which you in whichever you are weak, concentrate mostly on that particular subject as well as that particular topic. Okay, so and other important thing is coming to biology, just from genetics, you are going to get 16 to 18 questions. Okay, just from genetics. So now you might be understood how important is the genetics topic. Concentrate on genetics specially. Okay. See, coming to biology, 70% of the questions will directly come from insert. Okay. So if you concentrate on insert, 70% of biology marks will be in your pocket. Okay, coming to the exam, first start solving easy questions. First, you need to start solving with easy questions because all the questions in the paper will have equal marks. Okay, so first you need to start solving easy questions, and nobody are going to see whether you solved easy questions or difficult questions. At the end of the day, you need to get a good score in NEET. That's all matters. So first start solving with easy questions as soon as you begin the exam. Okay, so next, coming to the preparation tips, you need to concentrate on high weightage topics. Okay. See, in every subject, in physics, chemistry, as well as biology, there will be few high weightage topics. You need to concentrate on those particular topics in the beginning. Okay. See, only these high weightage topics will help you to score 600 plus marks in NEET. Okay, next tip is don't spend much time on single question. We all know we have very limited time coming to NEET, and within that limited time, we need to solve plenty questions and three different subjects. So before going to exam center, only fix your mind how much time you need to give for one particular question. For example, let's think you decided to give 1 minute for one question. Okay, so you decided so for example, let's think you decided to give 1 minute for one question. Okay, just let's take an example, and after 1 minute you need to automatically go to second question. You need to not spend much time on single question. Okay, so if you are unable to solve a particular question in a limited time, in the given time, just proceed with the next question. Okay, so and next important tip is you need to think and answer. Think and answer. See, there will be few questions. If you read first time, you will not know the answer. If you read second time, you'll get some idea about the question. Okay, so few questions will be really logical, where you need to at least read 2 to 3 times. Okay, read the question at least 2 to 3 times and think properly and answer. Okay, so and next important thing is time management. As I have already told you, time is very important. So coming to these particular exams, time management is really important. After completion of exams, once you come out of the exam hall, you should not regret for wasting time. Okay, so manage your time wisely. And next important thing is prioritize. Okay, what is meant by prioritize? Prioritize means you need to give priority to the topics which will help you to gain highest score. Okay, so whatever topics you know well, start solving them first, and whatever subjects you are confident with, start writing exam with those particular subjects. Okay, next important thing is read question paper once. Okay, before starting the exam, read question paper once. Once you read the question paper, you will understand the level of the paper. Is the paper easy? Is the paper lengthy? Is the paper difficult, moderate? All these things you will understand only once you go through the entire question paper. Okay, so once you get the rough knowledge about the paper, then you can start solving the paper by allocating the adequate time. Okay, and other thing which I would like to tell is, don't panic after checking the question paper. If you feel there are questions which you don't know the answers, don't worry at all. First start attempting the questions which you are very confident, because you're not the only student sitting there. If you feel the question paper is difficult, even the students who are writing exam with you, they also have the same difficulty level of the paper. Okay, so just be confident, you're not alone. Don't waste your time. The important tip is, read question carefully. First few times in a question, there will be words like what is not, what are not. If you miss reading not, then the answer is going to be wrong. Okay, so read the question very carefully.
Yeah, that's it for today. Hope you found this video useful. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that you'll never miss a video from Best Way to Study. And also don't forget to like and share this video with all your friends. Thanks for watching.